40 will start off on the T side, and Fnatic Academy jump onto the CT side.
So here we go, USPS is on the CT side, Glocks and 1 P250 on the T side. Two smokes and 2 flashbangs on the QWERTY side on Peter and Anna, so they're going to be the ones focusing their utility on getting somewhere, and it looks like it's going to be an A push, A split, basically. And that's already realized by some of the Fnatic players as they're rotating the rotator into the connector. And oh, look at that, that's a really nice job by QWERTY, faking out on that out of onside and then going in it. But look at that, Plessen shutting them down left, right, and center. Two guys going down straight to headshots.
Plessen already destroying 2 of them here now, so it's brought it over to 3 for QWERTY, but Karis, they let him get very close, but thankfully for the guys over here on QWERTY, Slap is able to handle it, but there's 2 more on the way, and he's not going to be able to survive that onslaught. Jay-Z Walkings takes him down, and look at this from Plessen. It's very aggressive. That is managed by Makalele, but Jay-Z Walkings picks up another kill. They're going to throw the smoke over the bomb, and Boten just jumps right on this here. They're trying to tap onto him, but Jay-Z Walkings will play on the ladder a little bit. He gets up close. We do see Makalele grab the kill, but it's of little consequence now, as Boten has defused the bomb, and Fnatic Academy have taken control of the pistol.
That was a really, really quick fake, by the way. Usually when we see pro teams at this level, when they fake out, they spend some time getting on and still leaving one player on the opposite bomb side or doing battle on the opposite bomb side. But they just straight out smoked, made some noise above Pop Dog, and then ran straight into inner bomb side. But luckily for Fnatic Academy, Plessen the rotator had already caught wind of this and actually were in the perfect position, grabbed the 2 openers, and now QWERTY forced on an eco because they did get their bomb down, so they've got to buy AKs in the next coming round.
And Plessen sits here waiting for it now, just basically expecting QWERTY to rush into this B bomb site. As you can see, he's got that Molotov in hand already prepared for it. QWERTY, for the most part here, since they did get the plant, they're not really going to bring much into this next round here. Just the P250 upgrades for a couple of them. Makalele, interestingly, brings in the armor, but that's about the most that they're going to bring over here to the table now. As we do see the Fnatic Academy guys, 2 of them actually fully committed to this site. They've sent 1 here to outer, but because of the position from Jay-Z Walkings, I highly doubt it's going to throw them off the B site. And yeah, now they know where the actual play is happening. Unfortunately, though, for Plessen, well, he did great in the first turn. He doesn't connect anything here. And it's Makalele that cleans up shop on the B site, takes down Golden and the Plessen. And now these guys have to try to rotate in, but they can't do that either because they've been cut off by a Molotov.
What an insane round for Makalele and the guys from QWERTY. Hits 1 in the mid-air, I think, with the USPS, and then goes to the battle against an SMG and wins that battle as well. And now 3 against 5. Wenton is low on HP, but look at it. Like, Peter getting another one onto Karis, and this is looking bleak for Fnatic Academy.
Look at this now from Boten, though. He's opened up with 2 more kills against Peter Natter. They are going to have to, you know, play to the clock here, as they're getting very low on time, but Boten and Jay-Z Walkie just picked up 2 more kills. It's on Wenton now. They can jump on it, but no. Wenton strikes from up top. He's got a smoke supporting from down below. Wenton, can he find this kill in time? And no, shooting at the complete wrong position. So Fnatic Academy will somehow piece things together, and Boten with the flick at the last moment also gets that last player dead.
Okay, so kind of like the same scenario at the end of the scenario as we saw in round number 1 where the bomb is planted. The CT smoked the bomb, jumped straight on it, and then afterwards, okay, that's the first one for Makalele, just to bring that back. And then the second duel, that's actually really nice for Makalele, taking those 2 duels and winning both of them. But not enough to QWERTY to grab that round, but now they have the full buy with those 2 frags. Makalele can afford AWP, full body armor, and also a smoke.
So, I mean, they've done the damage at the very least here, but they considering the situation that led up to the last couple seconds of that round, they absolutely should have taken it upside 1-1, so it's certainly disappointing for them to not take that. But in, you know, hindsight at the very least, they do the damage to Fnatic Academy, they bring them down to 1 player, and they get that 2nd plant. So this buy is actually really good, and Slap is going to open up with the 1st kill. Golden actually holding on the ladder here too, expecting a faster play outside of upper, but that's not going to be the case with the kill that they just got. They're now going to swing over here onto the outer bomb site. Since it's essentially open on the initial contact points here, as they do move in, Jay-Z Walkie just swinging off from the bomb tree, but he can't get anything. Venta takes him down. Boten is able to trade on the Slap at the very least, but he's stuck way over here in the back set, and he cannot stop them from taking control. They're going to pursue him. 2 players actually do line up. He gets the 1 further in the back there, and he looks at the 2nd one on top of the train. Nice adjustment as he takes down PETA. So now it's a 3v2 in the favor of the CTs, but keep in mind, 2 of them are heavily lit, and they're not going to be able to go out into the open as easily anymore. There's Adder finding Plessen, but Golden moves in on the rotate there. He takes down Adder on the trade. Makalele with a crucial miss shot allows Boten to swing out wide to finish the job against him, and they'll have plenty of time for the defuse to pick up a 3rd round.
What a run from Boten as well. Like, he's pressured really, really, really tough in that outer bomb site. His teammate dies, Jay-Z Walkings on that bomb train, and he still manages to hold it down, get the frags, get into defensive position, get 2, and then play defensively and wait for his teammates to arrive and then retake together with them. And this is it right now. We're looking at just holding that, getting that 2nd, and then just holding the defensive angle, seeing the 3rd one, seeing the bullets, and taking it out as well. What a round from the young Swede.
And so with that, obviously the money's still a little bit unstable, so it's not completely unjustifiable, especially with the buy that Cordy are able to get here for them to go right back into the next one. So they'll invest. They're still keeping the plans consistent. They're bringing this very close, but they just unfortunately keep whiffing out here on the last couple seconds of the play, yeah. Which is what allows Fnatic Academy to keep coming back into these and pick up three rounds.
So now JC Watkins on his pretty much brand gun, the AWP, and has full utility as well, as a kit and head armor. So he has pretty much everything he needs to make this round a good one for him. On the T side, we do see Michaela with all the utility, and the rest of the team just in UMPs or AK-47s, but it doesn't really matter because Karis just takes them out in the duels, which technically they should win, and JC Watkins coming in helping Karis, just gunning them down left, right, and center, and Peter, the guy with the utility, grabs up the AK and gets a double kill with it, but now the other guy's holding other angles and Blessing coming in from behind. There's no way he can clutch this.
We'll see what Peter can do here now, and it's not going to be much. JC Watkins with a quick dip out from the green drain, finds that last kill against him, and finally, I guess we could call that a cleaner round for the guys over there. Yeah.
Comparing to the first four, basically. Yeah. But yeah, there we go. That's going to be the scoreline coming in and getting even bigger for Fnatic Academy, and with them leading as well in map-wise score, then this is looking very, very good for them. 4-0, and the AWP for JC Watkins still alive. 4 Deagles and 1 CSET 75 for the Terrorists, and let's see if they can get anything out of this, because the last two rounds not been looking that good.
Yeah, we can see QWERTY finally being completely broken here too now, so the biggest buys that we have are like PETA with the CZ armor and the utility pickup. Wenton and Adder just going to go for the Deagles, along with armor, and McAlealy and Slap will pick up Deagles, but no armor to be seen behind them. Now, though, they wait as Slap takes up an early position down below at the bottom of the ladder room here. He's managed to get to this spot. We have seen them, however. This is kind of similar to the lineup they did in the last round, but the problem is they still really don't have enough utility, so it's open season essentially for Karis, unless they can distract him from the other end of it. He gets two, similarly to the last round there before going down to Venton, but now the alarm's been sounded that everybody's just gonna rotate in. Unless they can get this bomb planted soon, it's gonna be tough to do anything else here, but they're spreading across the site at the very least. They're making the Fnatic players hold. They're causing some hesitance on their own end here, as basically everybody's trying to defend themselves, and what JC Walking hasn't noticed is the player above him there. They're gonna double team him, they take him down, and it gets even out again into a 3v3, and now there's an op in the hands of Venton, but patience pays off for some of these other Fnatic guys. As Plessen, he's able to take down PETA. He smokes himself off a little bit to buy him some room to push out against the bomb, and this is the crucial thing too, is QWERTY can no longer fall back from this one, but there's Venton with another nice shot against Boat, and he takes him down. Plessen waits for that peek there, as Wenton knew that was a possibility, but still, the AK is going to beat out the Deagle in this situation, and now it falls to McAlealy. He's just given himself away, so they know where he is playing from. He saw that guy jump down to lower. He was hoping he'd go over towards Z, but it's not the case at all. So he's matched out, and Plessen's going to shut things down.
Yeah, good round from Plessen, good round from Karis as well, given those two individual frags in the beginning of the round, just holding back that push just a little bit, allowing his teammates to rotate in. And really nice play in the end there by Plessen, just using that position to his perfect, to the perfect round, really, from him. And there we go with the replay. That's a weird replay. Dropping these weapons around, making sure that JC Watkins constantly on that AWP, and that is an important factor, because that is the weapon that he is good with. He's decent with an AK-47, but you see the real difference when you get him on an AWP.
Just showing how the safeties hang out.
Yeah.
You know, 50 years ago in black and white with that replay. It's a good old throwback. Anyway. Getting into this next round here, QWERTY are able to reinvest once again, but it already has not started off well with Slap. They brought down to 48 HP, I believe, through them shooting the AK through the wall there. So they bring it down low. Plessen, he just spotted the one guy peeking into the back halls there, so he's going to toss up the Molotov to prevent them from pushing in. And this is already being sort of read here. While they won't fully rotate in, Plessen's already got an idea about what could be coming his way.
He's holding this down perfectly, and there's a teammate rotating to upper on that B bombs, and that's going to be golden. So now they have one player in each position. And that should be enough. Stop. Well, it'll be hard for Quest to get anything done.
Move in, Plessen waiting for more. He's going to be able to pick up a second frag now against McAlealy. QWERTY sneak themselves into the site. They can at the very least go for the plant. Wenton's going to act as a distraction as he takes down Boten over on the outer site. PETA's actually found a kill, but they don't realize that Plessen has snuck around. Thankfully, he whiffs his opening spray, so they certainly know he's here now. And Adder's going to finish the job, but still, Karis has picked up two more kills, and now it's all on Wenton, who's he's not even in the site right now. He's way over here. He just got to the box halls. He's got him. do not have one to work with, but he's going to roll out here. They're already well on their way to defusing it, though. And Venton, he takes way too long. He gets that first kill, but it is then taken down by Karus. And it's still going to be another round for the guys on Fnatic Academy.
Yeah, that's the problem with planning on the middle of that bomb chain. If you have a player that's playing that flank role and he's suddenly in a 1v2, then he has to rotate and rotate in towards the bomb site. He can't just look up or look lower and peek that bomb out that way. He has to rotate into the bomb site and kill the guy defusing. So that's a risky move, and that will allow Fnatic Academy to get in on 6-0. And well, the bomb is of course being planted, so money is existing for QWERTY, but right now they don't really need money. Of course they need that, but they also need rounds. They need to get on the scoreboard and at least get one round to see, okay, we can actually do this. That's going to do wonders for their self-confidence also. But so far, Fnatic Academy have been shutting them down.
Daisy Walking's just spotted the player that managed to sneak in under Nathan's nose here now as he sees those players from the T side moving closer. What he doesn't realize though is just how close they are. He can hear them now as they get close, and JZ Walkings off of the green train gets the no scope onto PETA. Look like he was going to go down, but it's not the case. Unfortunately though, he's lost two more of his teammates in the process, and as he tries to sneak out, he goes down. But Golden's looking to save the day as he just took down Makalele and Slap, evens it out, back down to the 2v2. He's going to sneak around E-Box here. It actually clips off a little bit of damage on Venton there as he tries to fall back into T-Comp, but the damage is traded just as evenly onto him. It's 2 versus 2. With one player on either team down to about 50.
See here, Adam trying to edge it in with his AK-47. Will take down Pleasant, and now it's looking really good. This is one of the better late rounds here we have for QWERTY. 2v1, Golden on 47, only one flashbang, doesn't even have a kid either. And they do have that bomb still with them on Wenton, so this is actually looking doable for QWERTY. Looks like they could grab their first round of this second map.
Golden caught off guard there, so Adder will finish the job. And QWERTY now, after many, many rounds, just like our last map to a certain degree, is going to put the guys from QWERTY back on the board.
Not a lot of celebration in the QWERTY camp. That round didn't really matter that much. Then there's no reason to clap being behind 1-6 here on train. But if they get a couple more, you'll probably see them get a bit more excited. But right now, they're still down pretty much unless they get something more done, because it hasn't looked so good for them so far. And definitely also has to tilt them a little bit that they've been so close for many, many rounds, especially the first two. And right now, luckily, since the rounds have been so close, Fnatic Academy will be on this scrappy buy on pistols and FAMAS, so they could string two together right now, QWERTY.
Lesson again, checking very quickly over there for the eventual push into the box walls. He spotted it on its way. But with the minimal investment here, he's going to be very, very careful. He only has that one smoke, and he's currently the solo player in the site. Now, we did get the rotation from Golden moving its way in, waited a few seconds, and it's a good thing, too, as it was just when these guys were about to actually push out of the ramp that he throws the smoke down. Now, there's obviously going to be some uncertainty in the QWERTY camp as to whether they actually want to push through this or not, how many players may be stacked on this site. So this is kind of going back to a more common strat we were seeing from QWERTY when they're actually losing by quite a bit. They started to play with A a bit more, and that's where they finally found their success. But out goes Plessen. He picks up the one, but quick rotations move in. There's Golden with a nice headshot, though, connecting one on the slap. He's got a lot more work to do, and obviously, he needs to buy a lot more time, but that's not going to play out. Makalele will take him down. Here comes the flank, though, from Karus over here. He's managed to work his way into the box halls, and there's another player on the way, too. Unfortunately, the player on the front end, that's Deji Walkings. He's gone down, and Karus with an AK is going to do massive damage. Gets the first one, transfers the spray onto the second. There's only one more to go. He's going to shut it down. Karus goes huge and single-handedly destroys the offensive from QWERTY.
What a round from Karus there. Has had a beast of a game so far here on train, and just locks that down with a triple kill in the end, and just basically one-handedly destroys QWERTY. And they did not count on that flank coming in. They were all three looking toward the end of the bomb trains, towards that CT spawn, looking for that normal push coming in from the CTs. But Karus just jumps in, gets the first, gets the second, and then the third after re-peeking, and didn't even need his teammate to back up from lower. He just took it all on his own.
Pause coming in now from the guys on QWERTY, very much so needed.
Yeah.
After finally finding success and seeming like they're actually going to have a pretty easy time of closing out that consecutive round there, just destroyed on a massive flank, which they did not account for at all. Adder tries to stop it at first, but it just happens so quickly, and they are not able to stop it.
And the question is also, are they going to buy here? Because they could do one of these that we've seen so far a lot of times, these scrappy buys where they get 2 or 3 AKs and utility. But they could also just do a Tech 9 utility push, maybe do that wall of smokes outside to get that bomb down, and then get money to buy maybe a double up setup on the T side in that next coming round. So that's probably what they're talking about right now. And generally also just taking a breather. It's very important when you get behind like this. Just take a breather and reset your mind, and then come into the next round and say, okay, this is 0-0. We forget everything that's happened so far, and we go into this like this was a new game.
So Karus, definitely the big man on the field so far for Fnatic Academy in this match. 11-6, I believe, is his current scoreline.
Definitely, he's been looking quite good, and he was actually already top of the scoreboard before he got that 3K in the end, and that certainly did help getting his position even further up.
We're still seeing Plessen remain as a consistent force too. He's been doing a really good job of playing up close onto that ramp position in the B side, sort of acting as a solo player when need be. And I mean the other problem here too is again, much like Cash, QWERTY's not doing a really great job of keeping their strats a mystery. They're sort of playing into it. So constantly the guys on Fnatic Academy are getting these early spots. Their aggression is working out for them. You know, these players holding the close angles, they're getting the intel early on, and then it's very easy for them to rotate into it and read it properly. So they're given, you know, infinite amount of time to set up for retakes round after round again.
Looking like it's playing into the ball court of Fnatic Academy. This is not a map that you would usually see a new team like QWERTY be very confident on. And so far, they're not looking very confident at all. We haven't seen that much from them strategically. They're not winning the duels that they need to win. In some rounds, they are, but it's the question of can they do that consistently? And that's just not possible for them so far. So it's definitely looking hard. And you can see the QWERTY players, they're not satisfied at all. They definitely want to do better coming into these next coming rounds. In this map number 2, it looks like we're almost ready to go, and we are now back in it. Round number 9, QWERTY versus Fnatic Academy, map 2.
QWERTY also, I think, have completely avoided Ivy too,
yeah,
so far. I don't think they've
100%.
I don't think they played a single player towards it yet, so that's another area of the map that they've basically ignored on this T side. They've just been going for very direct defaults on A, and then he just rushes into the B site. But Fnatic, I mean, again, they've got the read on this. Now they're going to fully commit too, and they've got one sitting at the backside. Plessen, he's just going to rack these kills up. 2, 3 already for Plessen, and Golden up on top has picked up a 4th. The 5th guy, Pita, is unfortunately stuck between a rock and a hard place here. There's nowhere for him to go, and Golden will get his 2nd kill, the 5th overall, and another easy one for Fnatic Academy.
Yeah, pat those stats. Ecofrags, man, are the best.
Absolutely.
Get you high on that HLTV.org ranking list, you know. Just getting those stats there. But of course, in a round like this, Plessen, there's just no way that QWERTY can do anything against that. He even gets the nade down the timing perfectly before they push into his UMP 45 and does even more damage, so it's even easier for him to gun them down. But now we do see Michael Ely with that AWP.
See Makaleli moving in too, hunting for an early frag, but none to be seen, and taking a little bit of damage from the Molotov. It's not anything too big, gets out of it quickly enough. Again, though, Jay-Z Walking's punishing the earlier player that tries to move back in. They finally try to use Ivy, and he takes down one. That's how it's gone down. Makaleli's been punished by Karis from up on top of Heaven, too. They're already down to 3, and we're only like 15 seconds into the round. Perfect flashbang from the CTs. The bomb goes down. I believe Karis would have spotted it, and it doesn't even matter. Karis is walking up here. Pita and Venton have both gone down to him. All of the E-box pressure is gone. I don't think Slap has been revealed yet, but still, this is tough. 1v5. Nice tap. However, on to Plessen, making it into a 1v3. Tries to do it again, but this time it's going to miss. All three of the remaining players are still at full HP, and finally, he meets his end at the hands of Jay-Z Walking.
I really like the thinking that thing is going on right now in Fnatic. It might be the coach saying this, but basically when QWERTY takes a timeout, they say, okay, they're probably going to run something standard on this save round they had before, but when they do the buy round, they probably have something special in store. So what's the one area where they haven't gone before? That's Ivy, and they put two players down. That's disgusting, that shot. But they put two players down towards Ivy, so they make absolutely sure that if they try something funny in an area they haven't gone before, they can lock it down completely, and they get that first kill there. And just having those two players on the Ivy towards that outer bomb site just perfectly, just saves them the round and just takes it once again. Fnatic Academy 9-1 right now, forces QWERTY on another eco. This is not looking good at all.
Button now is going to be watching out for the Ivy pressure, since QWERTY, after the pause, you know, just as we were talking about it, finally do decide to use it a little bit more here. Unfortunately, well, these eco rounds have not been met with much success so far. They were expecting the Opera to be playing it, and that's why they did the run boost over top to make it a little bit harder, and hoping that they can bait out the shot and then counter it, but not the case now. Jay-Z Walkings is really here more for support and to find the guys peeking out from Tekkon, which he's going to do that with these. Ooh, that's an uncharacteristic miss from him, and also the second one too. He's going to go down to Adder. Thankfully, Botan is here. He is able to move in and trade things out, but Venton also steals a kill off of Karis, taking him down further behind E-Box. A 3v2, and Botan spots one, but he's not down at 20 HP. He's going to have to molly this off. Kind of ducked down for now, but no, they're going to continue to chase through that. And Pita leaping through, grabs the kill on the Bolton. Golden, however, is taking down Venton. So once more, like many rounds of the past, it goes into the hands of Pita. The clutch is out 1v2, and he's going to go down to Plessen. A shot from super long range to finish him off.
And they grab the AWP from that Ivy and drop it onto JC Walkings, or drop it onto JC Walkings to begin the next round. So they still have that economy going. There's no reason for them to spend any extra money because they aren't really that strong on the cash. Like, Plessen is 2.9 despite them being in the lead 1-10, and it's going to be a bit hard for him to regain that control. But luckily, some of his teammates are around 10k, 7k, so money isn't that big of an issue, but still, you don't want to throw away an AWP, and they don't.
And we can can see now Boten is actually tired of this Ivy aggression, so he's just going to play up to it himself here. Moving in, the flashbang actually hits the tees there. It's perfectly played out. Unfortunately, they're a little bit too far back to be capitalized on by Boten here, but still, he knows something's amiss. He throws at the flash. This might be a little bit late. No, actually, he gets the first one. He almost picks up the second one. Adder is there to trade, but he's going to be restrained now because of that one, and that'll certainly buy some time for the CTs.
And Karas now taking care of this Ivy, holding two angles right now. He's holding Pop Dog and Ivy at the same time. So if they do a split towards that out of bomb side, then Karas is going to be in a lot of trouble. JC Wilkins holding very closely with that AWP. So an out of split right now would actually do wonders for QWERTY, because they have two man stacked on that inner bomb side, because they're of course worried about that push. But JC Wilkins shots Mykaleli down, and that's not a good start.
The bomb, I think they might have spotted off of that one too, so now they know, generally speaking, where the play is going to be working its way towards. It could still change, however, so we won't see any adjustments, but getting the spot on the spear line certainly helps. JC Walkings, though, actually caught up by that flashbang. He'll throw the Molotov out, but he's destroyed by Venton. Plessen and Karis, though, are still doing a fantastic job of holding onto this site, and Karis is just going to swing out from the green train to find that last kill. Slap goes down, and it's another one for Fnatic Academy as they go 11-1 against QWERTY here.
It's a hard knock life, and
a pineapple.
Yeah.
Why did someone bring a pineapple?
I don't know, man. I had pineapple in the green room. That was amazing.
It's like a really small pineapple.
I don't know, man. This is not the Caribbean, so maybe the pineapples don't get that large here. I'm not even sure if pineapples are from the Caribbean.
Can you grow pineapples in Germany?
You can grow them in greenhouses, so yes. You can grow them anywhere.
Yeah. Big trees, though.
Yeah, that is actually true. But right now, back into the game. Enough talk about the pineapples. We have 5 AKs and almost no utility on this QWERTY side. And as I was about to say, it's really a hard knock life right now for QWERTY. They're just getting wrecked everywhere. They pretty much go, and they have some close rounds, but it doesn't really matter if you can't really clutch these rounds in the end. So, yeah, already losing one man. That's Mykaleli going a bit too aggressive, not waiting for the rest of his team. And Slap going down to 4 HP. Still loads of utility on this CT side, so it's going to be incredibly hard for them to get into this bomb site and even get the bomb down. They're probably going to be shot down before that happens.
You can see now, again, they are getting prepared to move into it, but two here for Fnatic are ready for it. They've got players watching both of those angles, and QWERTY are doing a really good job of trying to box this out. Look at it, they have zero utility. They just have to rush this, and yeah. I mean, Fnatic still is plenty to throw in their direction here, too. So it's a bit stalemated right now. They're hoping the delay forces some of these players back, but there's Venton, though, opening things up on upper. He's going to act as a distraction. Now the guys on lower move in, and Plessen, he doesn't know which way to cover, so he's going to get taken down by Adder. This is exactly what they wanted here, the clean entry, and it's given them the chance to win the round. However, the rotations are now here. Karis moving in. He's picked up two. Venton has found his second, though, against JZ Walkings. But Karis moving forward now. He's going to have to watch out for these players, which are taking new positions behind the tanker that he's not aware of. It's going to be rough for him to make any more impact, but there's Boten moving in now. It falls to Adder at 45 HP. He's not giving himself up yet. He's playing this very well, but he cannot pick up the kills when it matters. Karis ends up with 3 on this round, and they're going to defuse it yet again, go 12-1.
And of course, it's nice to see QWERTY getting close and get the bomb down in these rounds, but let's be honest, that was not due to the fact that QWERTY was playing this one well. That was due to the fact that Fnatic were just unlucky with the timing and messing up a bit. So I'm really still left with the thought that I have not seen anything from QWERTY so far on this T side that is going to make me think, okay, they actually have a decent fighting chance. I'm waiting on the CT side, because that has to be absolutely magnificent for them to have a chance. But on the T side so far, QWERTY has been looking absolutely terrible.
And Karis now doesn't even care anymore. He's going to move himself up aggressively to play to the E-box. This time, he knows that he has full control over these guys, and getting an aggressive play like this would certainly help out to just completely break the morale of QWERTY. However, QWERTY aren't really moving into those positions to play to that yet. Most of them are hanging out in the White Halls and leading up to the Box Halls here too early on, kind of playing it by ear still, as they've got that one guy still sitting at T-Con.
Golden Hinge holding the angle they have. Once again, they have these support systems playing 2x2. And Golden holding up by that L-box, and just has a teammate with him. So it's not really a big problem if they push out at the same time, these terrorists, because this support structure of him and Karis can just hold it down. And they even have another pairing down towards the Ivy that can also help them out. And then they, of course, have the long playing JC Walkins with the AWP on the inner bomb side, who can take the first drag and then call for the retakes from the teammates. And actually, the call comes in now, one of the player rotating from that electric box position into the connector. But now the push comes outside and they have to all rotate towards A.
This is where the bite back comes in on Karis playing that aggressively here. JZ Walkings has to save it as they've lost Boten, but oh, he gets one through the smoke. That's 2 for him now. Unfortunately, his teammates aren't able to impact as well. Plessen goes down. It's just him in the 1v3. He tries to flick on to Peta, but it's not going to play off. And the guys from QWERTY finally pick up a second round.
Slight correction there. It was actually Plessen playing inside, not JC Walkins, because he was, of course, on that Ivy, where he's been playing for pretty much the entire half. half and just wrecking people left, right, and center. But we got something. We got something from QWERTY now. JC Walker is trying his best, but actually really nice execute towards the outer side, even forced the rotation from the players on that electric box double team to rotate inside. And when that rotate happened, they actually pushed outside. So the timing was really good from QWERTY, and something we haven't seen so far from them. So there is still hope. It's a slight hope, but it still exists.
And Makalele sneaking up here too to challenge things with Adder. Back over here by the Ivy position, Botany is going to be waiting for them, and the timing on the smoke is flawless, so they won't be able to impact on much for now unless they do decide to push through that, which is a slight possibility here as they now go for the boost. I mean, they just try to peer over the smoke, but Botany as well. Smart about that one, they won't play against that. However, Makalele actually got hit there. He's on a 2 HP now, so he'll have to back away from this one big time.
Yeah, definitely. 2 HP with an AWP, still can do some damage because of the way that the AWP pretty much works. If you miss one shot, you're basically dead either way. So that's probably, if you had to have one of your players taken out to 2 HP, Makalele right now would probably be the one that you want that happen to, because of his role and his weapon he's playing right now. But look at that, JC Walkins not playing with the AWP, playing very close range towards his T-Con.
He still waits for them to eventually move back in here. 45 seconds left. QWERTY are still trying to figure out how exactly they're going to move into this A site. But they need to make a move soon, with the time getting lower and lower here. PETA, though, has seemingly snuck in through Z. Karis goes for the check on it, but he's able to readjust, and that's where he's going to pick up the kill. And he also had another teammate there as an insurance possible to see. T-Con, however, is where most of the pressure is going to be moving in from, and Bolton strikes first there. He takes down Adder. Karis still on top of the green train. He's caught out by Slap, who pushes over there out from the ladder position. But now they're going to boost the guy on ticket, but they see this coming too. Slap not only gets him, but he gets the guy that boosted him up. That's Golden gone down. It's all on Bolton now in the 1v1, and Slap has utility advantage. He's got HP advantages. Everything going for him, but Bolton doesn't actually see him there behind the bomb tram, but he does get the angle advantage, and that's where he's going to destroy Slap and pick up yet another round for Fnatic Academy, and now for the second time reset QWERTY after they pick up their round.
I really like this ult there from Fnatic Academy, but because technically they could have dropped an AWP for JC Walkins, but then they would have lacked utility, but they decided to go for the utility and then put JC Walkins on an M4, playing in him kind of an aggressive position. Sadly for them, he doesn't really do much from that, but still doing that call of, okay, let's not put him on an AWP and get full utility. In my opinion, that's a better call 9 times out of 10.
So with the halftime being very much so in the favor of Fnatic Academy, it is now their set to lose, let alone their map to take here. As this was QWERTY's pick, but it's not seeming like that T side really held too much for them. Now we'll have to hope they bring something special on the second half, as things are looking grim.
Yeah, the one good thing for QWERTY right now is that Wentan has actually started up. He's really doing well. Stats-wise, he's been looking terrible from the basically first two maps in this tournament, but right now on this map, I think he's gotten double the frags that he'd gotten in the two maps before this. I think he was on 7 frags in total for the two first maps in this tournament, and so far he's on 15 to 13, actually the top fragger for QWERTY right now. So he's doing well. The rest of the team not doing that much. It's also hard, like two rounds, there's really not a lot you can read into that. They've been close a couple of times, that's true, but a CS game is won and lost on these clutches. And if you can't win the clutch scenarios, if you can't win the 1v1s, the 2v2s and stuff like that, you're just not going to win games and you're just not going to win tournaments.
We're getting into the second half now. If Fnatic Academy claim this pistol, it is essentially all but over unless there's an upset in the second round from QWERTY. And they invest pretty easily too here. The single kit coming in there on the PETA. Slap gets aggressive, however, pushes all the way up the ramp, and this is a big challenge. I've also got two guys over here down below in the ladder room. They call it out there. Karis is going to find Slap, but they've got to buy a guy further back there in the box holes. He's going to be taken down too. Here comes the flank though, but they don't get the Karis is right up front. He's able to pull out his pistol, take down Adder, and now he switches out to the USB too. The second guy that was there doesn't even get a chance at the action. Benton's far gone from this one, and he re-peeks. It goes right into Pleasant's headshot. Everything is on PETA now, but they had a great setup, just such a poor execution upon it. And off of that, Fnatic Academy are going to waltz right through this pistol round.
How do you not get Karis killed in that position? He wanted to pick up the USPS, did not get it, was with the knife, actually saw the CTs, heard the CTs coming in, goes for the Glock. And before he actually gets the Glock, they have the opportunity to kill him. But that just doesn't happen. He even has time to switch up, goes to the Glock, gets a frag, and switch back to the USPS. That was just weird.
Hitboxes.
Hitboxes, man.
Clearly.
Thank you, Gaben.
Well, now we will see Fnatic Academy on their second round here. Qwerty have invested, but Fnatic don't seem to care. Golden's walking right out here, gets himself an easy spot behind the E-box. Makaleli has found some luck so far here with this Deagle play, and he's going to be able to pick up not one, but two kills now. Karis and Plessen, and Karis again, they're trading out those frags, but Slap rolling it on the backside. However, he's not the last one alive in the 1v2. Finds an AK, they're both lined up, but he does great damage to Karis, bringing him down to 18 HP. He too, however, is low at 25. And he has to hold in this position. The smoke will allow him to cross, give him a bit more of a playground to work with. But still, so much is a mystery to him now that he smoked it off. There's the first kill, though. And I'm not sure if he's spotted the second, but he should know that he's out there now from the gunshot spraying in. He does not want to peek it, though. There's still so much time left. He can basically take this into ad infinitum, but no! It's not going to play out, and Golden is going to shut him down. Fnatic Academy will take the round, although it is very close.
Oh, that was really a close one, to be honest. Makaleli trying his very, very best, coming in with two huge deagle kills to the beginning of that. And I actually really liked the way that Slap played that round, coming in from behind, getting one kill, effectively a 1v3, getting the first one, then throwing down the smoke, and then goes for the second as well, but doesn't get it. But look at that from Makaleli, despite his team not being up to snuff, he is up to snuff with the deagles in that round.
So let's take a look here now. Fnatic Academy are just going to shut it down right here. If Qwerty still has something to fight against, they'd have to go 13 rounds straight to be able to take this into OT. Adder finding the first kill. Plessen trades, though, as he pushes the short lane. He gets a second one against Adder. They know there is another guy still sitting on that bomb train. Plessen at 17 HP destroys Wenton with the Glock in hand. And now there's only two left standing for Qwerty here. It's not looking good. They've battled their best, but they're down to one. And it's all on Slap, and they've already got a player paying attention to it. He tries to play this out. Gets the first kill. The final two know he's here, but he dinks Spoten. He actually brings him down to 2 HP. Swinging out, though, is going to be the rough part. There goes the nade. That should be a Kobe. And in fact, it is. He's only got Karis to worry about here, but this peak is so crucial. It's free for him. Karis fell back behind that orange train, and he picks up an AK too, and he's got a little bit of utility to toss back out, but he needs his kill in the next couple seconds. Yeah. He's got a kip, but that's still not going to buy him enough time, and now he sticks it here, goes off it for a second. He saw Karis peek behind him, but no, he doesn't even have enough time anyway. Karis is going to shut down the final kill, and Fnatic Academy will take this first set 2-0. They will move forward in the tournament, and unfortunately for Qwerty, they'll be our first team eliminated here. DreamHack Leipzig.
Yeah, what a game. And Fnatic Academy, after having a terrible start to the tournament, dismantles pretty much QWERTY. And there is a, yeah, that's of course sad to see, but there is definitely a clear victor in this one. There's definitely a clear best Swedish team in this tournament so far, and it is Fnatic Academy. Of course, sad to see. Commiserations to QWERTY. They tried their very best, but I think this team needs some more practice. But definitely when they get that practice in, I'm sure these are going to be a force to be reckoned with in the future. For this tournament, not right now, but definitely big congratulations to Fnatic.
A rough start indeed for Qwerty.